Hello and welcome to Young, Gifted and Brit. Now, around this table are four people that are definitely young, gifted, and are your passports all in order?
Yeah, just about.
Cool,
the
so
reasons,
they're all,
yes.
So you're British?
Yes, we're British.
Excellent. Now, to my furthest left, we have the star in the hood. It's Mr. Tinchy Stryder.
Yes, happening. Hello. How did you get through the doors on latch?
All in my system, you flow through that. And to my left, and her name is Jessie J. Next to me, repping Cash Money, and he also represents Hounslow, Mr. Jay Sean. Last but not least, one third of the Dynamite Trio, Mr. Fazer. I just can't live without them. They'll break your heart, don't doubt them. I'm the reason why she's never coming back. Simply can't leave me around them. Yeah. I'm Twin B, hello. Good afternoon, evening, morning, whatever. Now, it's exciting times at the moment for UK music. Mm. You've all had success here, abroad. How did you start, man? Where did it all start for you?
Long journey, man. Got my first record deal 9 years ago.
Wow.
Yeah, so it's been a long one for me. I used to mess with hip-hop then. I used to do, you know, I used to write rhymes. I used to produce
hip-hop. So you MC'd first?
I MC'd first. Okay. And that style of hip-hop back then was, it was very different, you know what I mean? And Funky DL, it was all those kind of witty lyrics. And so I had that, but we were told back then that we were never going to see the time of day. If you were doing UK hip hop, it was never going to happen. So it was kind of, you know, that's why I feel more proud when I see this explosion.
I remember
explosion.
Those days, man.
You know what I mean? The Indian scene had never, ever, ever had anyone from their scene do R&B or hip hop music. Yeah. So they were so proud. They were just like, wow, you know, we finally got someone from our background doing the music that we love. And finally, they had a poster boy,
and
I was the first, and that's when I got the attention of the record companies.
How did you meet music?
Oh, I did musical theatre. Okay. I was doing the jazz hands.
So you weren't an MC then?
I was Lady SV.
Really?
That was my tag name.
What did SV stand for?
Sweet voice.
Okay.
I just kind of fell in love with being on the stage and performance and character. I loved creating like voices and. And then I was signed 6 years ago.
Oh, nice.
So it's been a long time too. I feel like I haven't even got on the right jet, if that makes sense. I'm still queuing up.
For unsigned artists out there, you obviously all started off unsigned.
Yeah. Mm.
But how did you get to the attention of the labels?
I just open mics, singing everywhere. Just
wherever you could?
Yeah, just go and get reactions and film it. Everything I did, I filmed, because I would never have anyone say, you didn't start 6 years ago. I'll go on YouTube and I'm singing the same songs I was. As I am now.
So did you just stand on the street and then just start singing? Serious?
Yeah.
Did you put a hat down?
Nah, man.
Oh, man. Wasted opportunity, man.
So I was supporting Chris Brown by myself, 10,000 people a night, with just a CD, no management, no label. He booked me off YouTube. Going there and I paid for myself like to get flights around Europe.
Wow.
And I went on stage by myself. They booed me as I walked on and I booed them back.
I've got the mic, yeah.
And I was like, you've been on there for 5 minutes, just respect that. And I said, you might even like it, give it a chance.
Did you win the moment?
They loved it.
Tinchy.
Yo.
Where did you first meet music?
I was born in Ghana, but when I came up to Bath, like 13.
So are you British, just to clarify?
I am British, man.
You've got a passport, champ. Chan. Faye's going to hook me up.
We used to listen to a lot of like other MCs and thought, no, we want to do this, you know what I mean? And then start freestyling. We used to go in my house and then my brother's got turntables when he's mixing. We used to say other people's lyrics and just clash each other like, like, I'll be him and you be him. And then from now, man, I don't want to be him, I want to be me. So start writing my own lyrics, start from there, and then it's just been a journey, man. Yeah.
Excellent. And Fazer, I mean, you're also an MC, so was it the same for you?
Well, it was kind of mad for me and Dappy because I've known Dappy since I was young, since I was like 7, and then we kind of met up again in high school, and these times I was MCing, but I had like turntables in my house too, you know, everyone's there, so me and Dappy used to just go back to my house after school and sit in my yard for like hours just doing tapes, pretending we were on pirate radio station. It was kind of mad for us, and then we thought, oh, all right, let's get a group together, let's get in the studio. And then that's when Talisa came in, and then since then we've just been working.
And you became n-dubz.
Yeah, bro. People like us, n-dubz, it's like, our whole hype came from that. Like, we were sending stuff to record labels, packages for years, just sending stuff. People coming in, oh, you guys are going to be the next biggest thing, rare, broken promises after the next. Cut a long story short before, you know what? There was Channel U at the time.
Yeah.
So we done our first video, a £2.50 video. Crazy.
Crazy.
Man, it should have been about £2.50. It was done on a little camcorder. You should have seen my haircut, but I didn't even have a haircut. You know, them ones there, bushy trim. They got nighttime playlists on Channel U.
Right, so Tinch, Jesse, Fazer, Jay, thank you. Bye.
Thank you.
Peace.
Peace.
Bye.
Am I going to leave me hanging like that? Yes, you got me.